Following the large stream of immigration in 1940s and 50s Britain, cities across the nation were witnessing the beginning of a huge cultural shift. A majority of these immigrants were from Caribbean and West Indian descent and settled across Britain's cities. Throughout the decades, these diversifying cities gradually became more liberated and culturally rich. Musical subcultures and movements blossomed in sync with political and social unrest. From teddy boys and rockers to punks and mods and hippies of the swinging 60s, British subcultures and music scenes have progressively been influenced by social political circumstances. In the wake of the unemployment and dejection faced in the 1970s, Britain was in dire need of a new lease of life. In the 1980s and 90s, however, Britain began to witness the birth of a subculture unlike any had seen before. The nation were about to observe its biggest cultural shift since the 1960s. It was the birth of the raver. Doc Martens were swapped for trainers, flares substituted for tracksuits. It started amongst the hidden away movement of reggae dub in cities like Bristol. These cities became a catalyst for emerging genres like acid house, drum and bass, and jungle. Influences like these boosted the progression of dance music's popularity amongst young people. Brits, no matter what class or race, party together illegally under the roofs of unused warehouses. The angst of years gone by immediately forgotten amongst the ecstasy, smoke, and lasers. In amongst the euphoria, however, mainstream media played a large role in the crackdown on illegal parties, with striking newspaper headlines and articles bringing a lot more attention, albeit negative, to the rave scene. Police, rural landowners, and parents of rebellious teenagers were struck with a wave of unease and apprehensiveness. In order to understand how this mass hysteria came about, we need to go back to the roots. The true pioneers of the rave scene and the struggles they endured are not common knowledge. In and amongst the Afro-Caribbean presence in the district of St.Pauls in Bristol, late-night illegal drinking clubs began to form and craft a new musical genre simply named dub. A unique sound with its reggae roots evident in the work of significant artists like Lee Scratch Perry and King Tubby, as well as sound system crews like Jar Loco, Enterprise Imperial Hi-Fi, and The Wild Bunch. Bristol soundmen Froggy and John Lawrence even hosted an Excalibur set out the back of a van at Glastonbury in the mid-80s. Acts like these inspired the lower working class people of St. Paul's to push the sound and movement as far as possible. They did so through street raves. On every corner of every street, towering rigs of speakers with stacks of reggae vinyl were a common sight. Perhaps what obscures the vibrancy of St. Paul's were the April 1980 riots. One of the many illegal drinking clubs, the Black and White Calf, was targeted in a raid for alcohol on the 2nd of April. The Black and White Calf was more than an illegal drinking club, it was a drug den. According to Avon and Somerset Police, the property has been raided more times than any other premises in the country. Even after the 1980 riots, shootings and stabbings occurred at the site between rivaling gangs, with many cases being unreported. Venues such as Lakota and The Croft, now known as The Crofters' Rights, as well as The Dugout and The Full Moon Bar, with selectors The Wild Bunch having a residency at The Dugout before its closure in 1986. These highly regarded venues and their ravers thrived off underground's music's hedonism and in turn helped facilitate its path to the mainstream. One of the success stories to come out of Bristol's frantic underground scene started through Bristol's sound system crew The Wild Bunch, named after the Peckinpah film of 1969. Before Daddy G, Mushroom and graffiti artist turned rapper 3D went off to form Massive Attack, they were joined by Nele Hooper, Tricky, Willy Wee, DJ Milo and more. Some of the original Wild Bunch crew have contributed to Massive Attack's discography, with Tricky appearing on Massive Attack's debut album, Blue Lines, and Nele on Protection. The Wild Bunch's journey edged towards its end in the late 80s. After constant conflict and arguing, the group began to dissipate and head in different directions. In 1987, a year before Massive Attack formed, the Wild Bunch's Robert Del Naya, or 3D, appeared in a documentary about graffiti art for Channel 4. Alongside Wolverhampton-based DJ Goldie, who was experiencing a similar rise in popularity. It was this underground buzz that Massive Attack fed on, signing to Virgin and going on to release a vista of acclaimed albums and bodies of work. With debut album Blue Lines, Massive Attack and collaborator Sharon Nelson achieved their first chart hit with Unfinished Sympathy, partnered with an enchanting music video directed by Bailey Walsh. Three years later, Protection was released, featuring Tricky, who around this time was dating Icelandic superstar Bjork, who seemed to have a thing for figures of the UK underground, briefly dating Goldie around 1996. Over a period of 6 years, the group then released their two huge number one albums, Mezzanine and 100th Window. This success was soon continued 7 years later with Heligoland, in which they released eight low-budget films in promotion of the album.